commercial. It's a Wendy's commercial. And the scene is of an adult son who apparently is at Wendy's for breakfast with his mother. He's feasting on Wendy's French toast sticks. I've not had those yet, but he declares, good. No one makes French toast sticks like Wendy's. To which his mother responds, nobody. And he repeats, nobody. But then it's as if lightning strikes, although it's really his mother's strong glare at him with a tinge of sarcastic nobody that strikes him. And he then realizes that he's eating breakfast with someone who has made him home-fried French toast for years. Jesus said, your brother will rise. Martha said, I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day. And Jesus responds, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even if they die, will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. It was not a lightning strike. Jesus didn't say this with any tinge of sarcasm. Jesus spoke this with authority, with commitment, with love, and clarity of his mission from the get-go. With one single declaration, as he has done throughout the Gospels, time and time again, he challenges, yes, but also turns our experience of this life upside down, inside out, and every which way. He joined himself to our humanity so that we would see things differently, so that we would believe things differently, so that we would live life. Not at some future time, but now. Now in this very moment. As one homilist wrote, Jesus proclaims, I am life and I am life now. The deepest part of life is available to you now. Not just physical life, but the most important things of life. Your own dignity as a person is available to you now. Peace is available to you now. Joy is available to you now. And it flows precisely from your status as a child of God. It flows from your relationship with me. You know, I thought back and I remembered in my own life when I was a teenager and I was considering a vocation to the priesthood at that time. How after talking with some folks about it, doing some praying, and spending some time considering it on my own, how I decided at that time that I was going to go in a different direction. I was going to take a different path so that I could, now these are the words I use, live and experience life first. As if becoming a priest would remove me from the rest of humanity and the life that we share. My friends, you and I can become very much like Martha in this case, missing what's present to us in this case, life. Life that was standing right in front of her, the source of all life, postponing it until all the conditions are in place that we're convinced are necessary for life to happen. It becomes a future experience only if certain conditions are met. After we graduate from college, after we find the right person to spend the rest of our lives with, after we land the right job or career, save enough money, successfully participate in every sport we possibly can, and the list is endless. Since you see, there always seems to be one more condition that we add. But Jesus reminds us this isn't the case. Jesus, the Redeemer and Savior, is in our midst now, the one who is vulnerable enough, yet powerful enough, to come to us in bread important and significant as it is, but it doesn't lead us to life. Life in particular, life in Christ allows us to experience all else and experience it in a new way. Now, certainly I would be less than faithful to the gospel if I left us here, since you see, Martha does get this. Proof of this is in her confession of faith. Even before Jesus acts, she responds to his next question in their dialogue. Again, Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" And Martha said, "Yes, yes. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." Let us never miss the life that is ours in Christ now. For without it, the eternal life yet to be would not be possible. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. In and through our baptism into Christ Jesus, we have been freed from the bonds of sin and given the promise of new life. As children of one God in confidence, let us raise our voice in prayer.
That wherever the power of death holds people bound, the church may summon forth life in the name of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders of our world may work together to guard and protect, in these days, the people entrusted to their care, especially the most vulnerable among us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who mourn the loss of loved ones may experience the comfort of Christ in our community, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the elect of the church, through baptism, along with candidates to be received in the church, confirmed and welcomed to the table of the Lord, as well as our candidates for confirmation and the reception of First Communion, will experience Christ, who calls all to life, unbinds them, and lets them go free, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and suffering, especially Fred Burkhart, John Chartarino, Bob Christian, Vanessa Corey, Danny Firth, Flo Floss Firth, Mike Firth, Dacia Fertney, Patricia Hartman, Julianne Jenkins, Dan Klein, Dan Lane, Ray Lieber, Tom Lorkowski, Joyce Moore, Dora Petrocki, Brooke Russell, Carol Scaley, Katrina Shunk, Paula Simmons, Janet Treat, Clara Whitus, John Wright, Ron Hilke, as well as the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may, like Martha, seek the Lord who restores them to life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have recently died, along with Frank Masella, for whom this Mass is offered, and all those who have gone to their rest, may hear the voice of Jesus calling them forth to life and resurrection, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may confidently entrust to God the needs that remain deep in our minds and hearts, those written in our prayer notes book, as well as those we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God of eternal life, whose glory is the human person fully aligned, the tears that Jesus shed for Lazarus, his friend, we see the living incarnation of your tenderness and compassion. Graciously behold the distress of your church, which mourns and prays as a mother for her children, whose sins have brought them death. By the power of your Spirit, call them back to life, unbind them, and let them go free. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant will sing in every age, and it's number 472.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our Lord, and of all his holy church.
Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your service the teachings of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of this sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as true man, he wept for Lazarus, his friend, and as Eternal God, raised him from the tomb, just as taking pity on the human race, he leads us by sacred mysteries to new life. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing their mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Everyone who lives and believes in me will not die forever, says the Lord. Our communion chant, let's sing together, I Am the Bread of Life, and it's number 329.
Thank you.
pray Almighty God, that we may always be common among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
A constant thank you to those giving up their time and their talent to support your parish's mission and ministry, as well as the gift of treasure. Envelope users, we always remind you, please be aware of the collection boxes at the entrance of the church. And if when you come in you smell this freshness, we want to thank all of those who showed up on Friday to help spring clean the church. They did an excellent job. Very grateful to them. We're grateful to them. Don't forget, Lent and alms are still being collected. That will take place through and including Holy Thursday. There are baskets at the entrance of the church forehead. Variety reminders for this week. Stations of the Cross will be praised Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. in church. Next Saturday, weather permitting, gather at 4:45 p.m. at the Circle for the blessing of palms and a procession to the church for Mass that will continue at 5 p.m. here. If the weather doesn't cooperate, well, then we all show up here and we'll be here. For that particular Mass, if we do start at the Circle, the palms that are blessed at the Circle will be distributed after Mass for the 5 p.m. At 8:30 and 11 a.m., everything will happen here. So again, we hope to see you. We hope the weather cooperates. I can't believe that it's only, incidentally, wear your red next weekend. Stations of the Cross then next Sunday will take place in church at 4 p.m. Due to a variety of uncontrollable circumstances, they will not be the mime stations this year, but they will be a tweaked version, if you will, of the stations. So we hope to see you next Sunday. Tuesday of this week, March 28th, we need help at 11:30 a.m. As we have alluded to or mentioned, we will be hosting the Eucharistic Miracles display that's on loan to the diocese. We will be hosting that the weekend. It starts the weekend of May 6th and 7th. It will be here for a week, so stay tuned for more details. But again, for a variety of circumstances, we had to pivot and receive all those materials this Tuesday, March 28th at 11:30 a.m. My understanding is it is a truckload of stuff, so that's why we're asking for help to unload so that we can store it. So if you're available, we hope to see you there. Some wonderful news for this year's Catholic Charities Appeal for this parish in particular, we are at 65% of our goal. This year's campaign is $74,429. We still have a ways to go. I can't write a check for the difference. So it's important, though, that we do meet that goal by May 1st. If you've not yet responded, please, please do so. If you have the materials at home, get them sent in. If you've lost them or misplaced them, there are pledge cards, pledge envelopes, if you will, on the carts near the entrance of the church. So again, we thank you for those who have responded, and we look forward to meeting that goal by May 1st. Resources for Holy Week are already out. We thought that you might want to get a running start on that, so those are available on tables near the entrance of the church. All we ask is a free will offering. I apologize for the wind and the sound confusion or whatever else, the sound distortion, variety of things this weekend. I assure you, I did preach. The homily was great. If you didn't hear it, it was great. So God bless you. God, basically it was God bless you, so do I. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. Bless, O Lord, your people who long for the gift of your mercy. Grant that what, at your prompting, they desire, they may receive by your generous gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And I forgot, tomorrow at 2 p.m., we're showing a movie that has been provided by the Knights of Columbus on Blessed St. Teresa of Calcutta. That'll be in 101, so we hope you'll join us. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please sing together, In Christ Alone, and it's number 400.